please.
Sir, I rise to speak in support of the Indian Institute of Information Technology Amendment Bill 2017. Sir, I wish to make 3 points on this bill once order is restored in the House. Sir, I wish to make 3 points on the amendment bill that has been brought this evening. Sir, just 6 days ago, we passed another bill which was called the Indian Institute of Information Technology Public-Private Partnership Bill 2017. Sir, the first point I want to make is that now we have 3 categories of triple ITs in the country. Sir,
you speak.
We have now created 3 categories of triple ITs in the country. The first category is International Institute of Information Technology that exists in Bangalore, Hyderabad, and Pune. 6 days ago, we passed a bill that creates a second category of triple ITs, which is called Indian Institute, not International Institute, but Indian Institute of Information Technology Public-Private Partnership. And there are 15 such triple ITs, which we passed on the 10th of July. Today, we are passing a third category of triple ITs, Indian Institute of Information Technology, but not public-private partnership, but funded entirely by the central government. And these are 5 in number, 4 are existing. The 5th one is what we are passing today to be in consonance with the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act 2014, the triple IT in Kurnool. So my first request to the Honorable Minister, triple IT, International Institute in 3 cities, triple IT, Indian Institute in 15 cities, but in PPP mode. And now, 5 more triple ITs with 100% central government funding. My request to the Honorable Minister, at some point of time, rationalize the structure of triple ITs. Because triple ITs, like IITs, like IIMs, have become a brand. And we should have one common legislation covering all triple ITs. It's not possible today, but maybe in the next session or thereafter, the Honorable Minister may consider this suggestion. Sir, the Honorable Minister, in his opening remarks, was kind enough to say that the bill that we are passing today is basically a follow-up to the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act 2014, the 13th schedule of which gives a number of educational institutions which the House agreed should be set up in the successor state of Andhra Pradesh. So this included one IIT that has been set up, one NIT that has been set up, one IIM that has been set up, one ICER that has been set up, one central university that has not been set up, one petroleum university that has been set up, one agricultural university not been set up, and one triple IT which we are setting up today. So my request to the Honorable Minister is, please take expeditious action on fulfilling the commitment on setting up a central university in the successor state of Andhra Pradesh, one central university, one agricultural university, and one tribal university, all of which that are promised in the 13th schedule. So, my second point is the following.
Third point, I hear.
All over the world, the movement is towards convergence. But unfortunately, in our country, the movement is towards fragmentation. And I would like the Honorable Minister to give some thought as to how we can bring these institutions together. Triple IITs cannot function in isolation of the IITs. Triple IITs cannot function in isolation of universities. And I think at some stage, we need to bring all these institutions working in a collaborative mode, in partnership mode, particularly when they are not far off from each other. The Triple IIT that we are passing today is in Kurnool. The IIT is in Tirupati. And it is perfectly possible for the IIT in Tirupati and the Triple IIT in Kurnool to work in partnership mode, collaboration mode. This is a request I'd like to make to the Honorable Minister. Sir, my third and final point. This morning, the Honorable Minister answered a question from my colleague, Sri P.L. Punia. It was a starred question, but it didn't come for the answer.
No need.
But his answer I have in front of me. It's a very, very depressing scenario for faculty in institutions of higher learning. Sir, I am surprised. I myself am a product of one of these IITs. And I am surprised that, and this is not a political point, this was the same situation when we were in power, this is the same situation when you are in power. 39% vacancy position, not in the new IITs, in the old IITs, IIT Mumbai, IIT Chennai, IIT Kharagpur, IIT Delhi. IIT Delhi has a 45% vacancy for faculty. So the Minister of Health is sitting next to the Minister for HRD. We are setting up AIIMS-type institutions all over the country. In our country, there is no shortage of students, but there is a shortage of faculty. There is no shortage of youngsters wanting good education, but there is a shortage of teachers providing good education. So we are setting up triple IITs, we are setting up IITs, we are setting up IIMs, we are setting up AIIMS, which we must. Unfortunately, we are not having the same success in attracting faculty. And I would like the Honorable Minister, sir, today is not the day, but at some stage, we must address the question, why our institutions of higher education and excellence are not attracting the best faculty. And even an IIT, of which, sir, you have been the chairman, I hope you will not ring the bell, because you have been the chairman of IIT Delhi. IIT Delhi has a 45% vacancy of faculty.
It was not so at that time.
This is an unacceptable situation.
It was not so at that time.
The Honorable Minister to consider these issues. We will, of course, pass this bill today.
Thank you.
But these are structural issues which affect higher education.
Good points. Thank you. You made very good points. I accept that.